Oh, Maharaj, Radhesham. Bhakti Prapana Tirtha Maharaj ki jai. Dandavats. Revolt Tirtha Maharaj.
Mataji, aap complete karenge.
No, he's speaking English. Maharaj speaks perfectly English. So we are very lucky Tirtha Maharaj has come to continue his class he gave the other day.
I'm happy. Just morning I'm remembering at that time what is going there for some.
Wow.
So at that time he went. It's very good. I'm thinking to come and see Maharaj. So at that time he went. Okay, joy, joy. You continue.
No. I was just substituting you in the. I was just giving an introduction on the beauty of. We were singing Sharanagati. Atmani Vedanam Tuva Padak.
Yeah.
So we were singing this song, and then I was telling that everybody wants to be Krishna in this world, and it doesn't work. So therefore, we went. Langsi? Good. Yes?
Jai. Very happy to see you all. I just heard.
Bansi, you take for him. Put another garlic.
To you, this is.
I know him, I think I've seen him.
Yes.
Jai.
He cannot do Dandavati, he has his back pain. So he must do Dandavat in the mind.
Yes.
So we were discussing that and I was trying to explain how everybody wants to be the boss, but it never works out that way. Anyhow, now we simply request you to continue, because actually last time when you were here, you were translating from the book so much, but we didn't hear much from you, from your own
when you are here,
appreciation.
What I can say, you are more, no more than me. You have so nice devotional atmosphere I'm seeing here. And I'm actually feeling very joy. It is saying, Tirtha Jatra. Shapholo Amar, Jodhapi Dekhilam Charano Tomar. When Mahaprabhu went to Gaya for his father, that Shraddha ceremony, then he meets Ishwar Puripad, right? And then he told that my Gaya Jatra is successful, Gaya Jatra Shaphol. Jodhapi Dekhilam Charano Tomar. When I have seen your lotus feet in this Gaya Tirtha, then my Tirtha Yatra is successful. Je Tirthe Vaishnav Nai, She Tirthe Nahi Jai. Narottam Das Thakur is saying, we have not to go that Tirtha, there is no Vaishnav. So when we come here in Vrindavan, if I not see Vaishnav, then what? What I can understand, what I shall get. One time I remember when I came to Guru Maharaj, first I came, but I'm not initiated. But I seen Guru Maharaj, I like him very much. then, but my mind, you know, mind is very bad. So then I, 99% I am decided I have to take shelter from him. But I am coming from a, mane, some Vaishnava family. So 1% some, my father, they not so much Gaudiya Math there. They are also Vaishnava, but they not like so much. Because they Gaudiya Math, mane, Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Prabhupada, attacking all the Goswami, etc., etc., etc. And my father, all this from that sect. Eh? So, but I am attracting from the beginning. At first, I meet Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Mahadeva Goswami, a disciple in my village. Because they have more.
Where's your village?
Near Guwahati. My village is near Guwahati. You know Guwahati? Assam.
In Assam.
Assam.
You're from Assam?
Yes. I'm Assam. Originally from East Bengal. Then I'm brought up in Assam.
Like Bhakti Balabdita.
Yes, same. So I first seen Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur picture in Chaitanya Gaudiya Math in Guwahati Paltan Bazar, right? And that time, because it is near like 2 or 3 hours from Guwahati to my village, half village, something, some half town, that is called Hojai. So there, near our house, some sannyasi, brahmachari going to preach. And I meet, and I like Gaudiya Math, my father not like. Then I used to go and listen and doing parikrama with them. And then I'm attracted to come. It is better than what my father doing. My father is something Goswami, something.
What Goswami?
I don't know how to say. Like this, he has so many Goswamis. My father also.
What line?
Oh, their line is, Navadip Goswami, Navadip.
Navadip Goswami.
They are the disciple of Navadip Goswami, right?
Please.
You have to sit down. Maybe in this. Yes. So, in this way, I'm attracted fast.
Navadvip Goswami, what family, what temple? Yeah,
they are in
Sona Gauranga?
No, there is Jagannath Badi. Now they all disappeared. Navadvip, there is a Jagannath Badi. And he is some Goswami, right? And
Jagannath Badi.
Yes, in Jagannath Tala.
That temple still exists?
Still exists. They sometimes, now all disappear the families. But my father is from there. They are from Advaita Parivar or something like that.
It's Advaita Parivar.
Yes, yes. But I am more attracted to Gaudiya Math. Like, then I come, and then I first come to Guru Maharaj. Through, by the mercy of His Divine Grace, Lesi Bhaktivedanta Swami Maharaj. Because when I am, Swami Maharaj Prabhupada, when I am in house, I am reading newspaper, etc. I am seeing house, so Swami Maharaj Prabhupada doing so big, Mahaprabhu's preaching, he distributing Mahaprabhu. And I am also like Mahaprabhu. So I am thinking I must join there when I am reading in college or something. So, but I came and I meet some devotee, Vidyadhara Maharaj, no, his name is Sarvabhavana Prabhu of ISKCON.
Sarvabhavana?
Yes. I meet him finally.
From Germany?
Yes. He's Calcutta from Germany.
Yes.
So by his mercy, I got Guru Maharaj. At that time, Vidyadhara was there in 1982. So
Vidyadhara was in the math?
Yes, yes. 82-83, he is there. I am always with him. I am also attracted. Then I went to Mayapur, but I not found anyone to hear or discuss. Nitai is the president. What is it? Maharaj's name, I forgot. Then I come to Calcutta.
In Chaitanya Saraswati?
No, in ISKCON.
Nitai.
What is his name?
Nitai Chand.
Nitai Chand, right. He's the president. So I not actually found anyone to listen. Then I come to Calcutta and Albert Road. Then I meet Sarvabhavana. Then I hear his words and I feel a little nice. He's singing some sweet. And then I approach him, though I actually looking a real guru, real saint, real sadhu. I don't want. So if you know how he's speaking, I feel very nice. He's speaking very nice. Then that time he going to Guru Maharaj, and his son also initiated from Guru Maharaj. So then I want to stay there, but he said, no, you write a letter, you go, what you looking for, you'll get it. Then I come to Guru Maharaj, Ambishnupad Sri Bhakti Rakhak, Sri Deva Sri Maharaj. Then I 99% I like Guru Maharaj, but 1% little, because I am actually previous connection. Then sometimes I go back and I like, then again I come, then I told Guru Maharaj, I want to go to Vrindavan. That time I heard that University of Bon Maharaj, because I read that, oh, there is a university, Vaishnava University, I must go and read there. That is, I was thinking, after finishing my that school, college education, I thought I want to learn Vaishnavism, and so better to go that university, just very hard. After seeing Guru Maharaj, still something working, something like that, right? That time I don't, not so much expert, but I asked Guru Maharaj, I want to go there. That time I'm not initiated, I'm so foolish. Then Guru Maharaj said, no, why you go to Vrindavan? You go to see some plant or trees, etc. Then you got to go, because say, Guru Maharaj is a real Vrindavan. That work letter, little letter. Then I, because of mind, I'm listening mind that time, 99% just 1% I'm thinking, oh, I must become little educated by these things, etc. Then Vaishnava University, etc. That time just leave my university, material university. I left material university. And then I'm thinking I must admit in Vaishnava University. And then Guru Maharaj is the big Vaishnava University, that I don't understand that moment. But then I come to Howrah and I went to station for the ticket. Then something working of Guru Maharaj saying, then I cannot cut ticket. I go back. So this is where that means. That time Guru Maharaj told, you going Vrindavan to see some plants or forest? That work letter. When I go up to, then I thought, yes, where I go Vrindavan? Where I shall go? I don't know anyone in Vrindavan. But I like this saint Guru Maharaj, I like. Then I come back. Then I come back and tell Guru Maharaj, oh, I'm not gone, I come to you now. I want to be here, please. This way. So I'm saying, so this our Vrindavan Jatra also will be successful if we meet some saint. Gayatra Shafalo Amar Jodhupi Dekhilam Charano Tumar. So I'm come here, I'm also very feel from the beginning when Maharaj Srimad Bhakti Alok Paramadvaiti Maharaj trying to serve the Dham, serve the Vaishnava. Meaning everything belongs to our Vaishnava world. So I am feeling very attracted, but maybe I mean cannot come. And this time he is telling, oh Maharaj, you take some seva responsibility. Then I am saying, oh, if some seva responsibility we cannot ignore, and it is simply the name is so nice. That World Vaishnava Association or Vishwa Vaishnava Rasava, the name simply is so beautiful. No name will be like that. And we are the Vaishnava world is not a limited things. It is, we are Bhaktivinoda Thakur saying, Vaishnava is ready to honor all men without distinction of caste. See how universal is the religion of Bhagavatam. It is not intended for a certain class of Hindus alone, but is a gift to man at large, in whatever country is born, in whatever society is bred. In short, Vaishnavism is the absolute love, binding all men together with the absolute. This is Vaishnavism, right? This is Vaishnavism. What Mahaprabhu given, and our Guru Varga like Bhakti Vinod Thakur, Bhakti Siddhanta Thakur, they again and again told us. But we want a broad way to serve. Why not? What is wrong? If we broadly, and Maharaj liked this idea, and he took seriously, and we see Maharaj sometimes say, oh, we are not getting so much response from our Indian or Vaishnava, etc. But I'm saying, I told Maharaj, oh, we have not, I shall not worry. When Srila Isi Bhaktivinoda Swami Maharaj start, sometimes he not got so much support. But he did not stop, right? He not stop. And finally, he went to West. And how much support? That means everything is the will of Lord. If we take it, we have to try our best and see what he wants. So in this way, I'm actually very happy that if we can serve widely this Vaishnava community, Vaishnava world, it is great. I think in this way we can make more happy to our Guru Varga. Because they done this. They come for this and they done this. I was told that when Srila Swami Maharaj returned and Guru Maharaj was so happy and he told that actually I'm seeing he fulfilled the desire of his Gurudev means Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur's desire to spread Krishna consciousness everywhere in the world. And he, how nicely, by him, it is happened. So therefore, Guru Maharaj is saying, I'm happy, I'm proud, I'm very proud that one of my God brothers, and therefore we also try to satisfy the manavishta of our Guru Varga. Their manavishta, what? That I must do, I shall follow Krishna consciousness, I shall try to help others to follow Krishna consciousness. Not just a limited way, that is, I not like, I think a real Vaishnava also not like, that we are stay in a small house, because our Guru Varga want a big house, and that everyone can get some place there, right? Everyone. So, but though we know all Guru Varga has different mission, but still it is possible if we unite. And Maharaj giving so much importance, he's taking it so seriously, and with his, all his devoted disciple, he's trying and trying to clean Vrindavan, trying to clean our Mayapur, and so nice. It is, I think, this way we can please Radharani. She is her place, and if we please her place, her dham, one devotee asking Guru Maharaj, how we can please Nityananda Prabhu? Because if we not please Nityananda Prabhu, then we cannot please Mahaprabhu. Then Guru Maharaj saying, oh, if we take care of Navadi dham, then Nityananda will be very happy. Because Nityananda taking care of this Mahaprabhu's ashram, Mahaprabhu's place, Mahaprabhu's, Krishna's everything, looking after Balaram. So if we take care what they are doing, then they will be more happy, more satisfied. So in this way, I'm also, it is my heart also, how we can do some dhamma shiva, some Vaishnava shiva, it is in my heart. But I'm very small man. I cannot do, I'm thinking like a theoretical man. I'm thinking. But when Maharaj other day, many times from long before, saying that, oh, you can be help in this, then I'm saying, oh, it's very nice. It is Maharaj not saying for himself. He's saying a big Vaishnava community, a Vaishnava world, and the world, it is the world of our Guru Varga, and it is the world of Mahaprabhu, it is Krishna. So why I shall not try? So in this way, I'm also happy, and I have other day Maharaj and Arup Govinda Prabhu from the book Saraswata Jayasri, that book I read, about that Vishnu Vaishnava Ratsava, that what is the function of Vishnu Vaishnava Ratsava. And I'm very much inspired. So, oh yes, it is our Guru Varga wants. Jiva Goswami, Rupa Goswami wanted that. Jiva Goswami wanted that. That we must combinedly, unitedly. Sankirtan means what? Sankirtan means Bahujana Milita Jakirtan Sa Sankirtan. The meaning of Sankirtan, you know, that Bahujana Milita. Sankirtan means not. Kirtan means I'm alone playing bhajan, that is Kirtan. But Sankirtan means Bahujana Milita Jakirtan. With many, when I'm doing, glorifying the Lord, doing some Seva, doing, protecting our Sampradaya, that is Sankirtan. Guru Maharaj is saying, Sankirtan is also like fighting, right? To fight with the opposite dhanta, fight with the misconception. This is also Sankirtan, not just to make kartal and doing kirtan. It is not only Sankirtan. Sankirtan is like we buy magazine, buy our newspaper, when our now we got some, what say, our internet, what is it? It is Prabhupada saying Brihat Medanga to this press, right? So internet is like a Brihat Brihat Medanga. Today, so internet is a Brihat Brihat Medanga. Yeah, it is more than that any way we can preach. So this way, it is, and I'm thinking I'm very fortunate when I got so many nice, our Guru Varga and so many nice devotees. Why I'm saying I'm unfortunate? Yes, I'm unfortunate because my lack of devotion, my lack of humility, my lack of many good qualifications, I'm unfortunate. But at the same time, we can say I'm fortunate when I found so many nice Vaishnavas. In this way, I'm always grateful to Lord, right? He has given me. But my fault is that I am not serious, I'm lazy, and I'm not doing as much as necessary. That is my sadness. But I'm grateful to Lord that He has given so nice Vaishnava in this world, and I got this, I found this. So in this way, if we, then my energy will be increased. I may be small, that story, you know, that ocean taken away the egg of that small bird, right? And the bird, small bird, become, ocean, you return my egg, that means my baby, you return. Why? Then ocean, why to listen this small bird? Ocean is so big, then if you not listen, then I shall take proper ocean. Then he went to Garuda, right? His bird, Garuda is bird. And so by this way, then ocean become afraid, right? He has a connection with Garuda. So I'm thinking, I am very small, but if I have a connection with our great Guru Varga, then I am not small. In this way, we can do many things, right? So only need mercy of our Guru Varga, the Vaishnavas, that is everything. Without their mercy, I am nothing, right? Other day in that meeting in Radhakunda, they given me 10 minutes chance of Srila Bhakti Pramod Puri Goswami Maharaj's disappearance day, and also be told to say about Guru Tattva. So we always that if we live in our, just like example given, Guru Maharaj given, then like Guru is like a water and disciple is like a lotus, and Krishna is like sun, right? So if a disciple like a lotus stay always in the water, the sun will nourish, right? Will give so much nourishment that the lotus will bloom nicely, right? But if the lotus is out of the water, then even the sun will burn, right? So no use of anything if we not remain in the feet of Guru Vaishnava, and Vaishnava is also Guru. So in this way, our necessity to stay always with them, and stay with his, we heard that it just stay and not only stay, but serve and stay. Sangha means to serve. So without service, our life is nothing. So if we can do some service, that is, will give us something. Service, service, service. Service is our life. Service will not take. I want to die. By this song you say, Tomorrow Shivai, Dukkha Hai Jato, Shevuto Paramashukh. Sheva Shukha Dukha Parama Sampada Nashoi Avidya Dukh. Bhaktivinoda Thakur so nicely saying in this song, Atmani Vedan, in this song, saying that Sheva, if I get some heavy maneki wale pain or misery, I don't care. That is my wealth. Sheva Shukha Dukha Parama Sampada. It is wealth. Because I understand. The otherwise, we are in the material world, we are getting so much suffering, so much pain. Nobody is out of that, right? But if for Krishna I get, it is good. I want to die for Krishna. I want to suffer for Krishna. I heard Bhakti Swaranga or Guru Bhargava Goswami Maharaj saying, sometimes I'm feeling, oh, I'm very sick mentally. Then I cannot do seva, then I'm feeling sad. Oh, my mind is so weak now, I cannot do seva. Then sometimes I approach some Vaishnava guru, oh, I'm saying. Then it's, oh, no, you know, why you are weak? Because Bhakti Sanat Goswami Maharaj used to say, I want to die in harness. Harness means, but you heard the meaning, by on the horse, by doing fighting, I want to die. In my life, I want to cannot be sad that. So this is our life. Service our
Bhakti
life.
Vinod Thakur says he wants to die in harness.
In Bhakti Saranga Goswami Maharaj.
Oh, Goswami Maharaj.
Yes.
Said.
So we want to die. We have no time to without service. So that service is Guru Maharaj saying service will give you us life. Service, service, service. Service will give us life. That is. Service will not take our energy, it will give our more energy. If we engage in service, we get more service. And Mahaprabhu told that Brahmin, that is my order. Jare dakho, tare kaho Krishna upadesh. Amar akai guru hoya, taro ei desh. The Brahmin want to go with Mahaprabhu, right? When that Kurma Bipra, right? Then Mahaprabhu said, no, you stay in your village. No, he's afraid, my village, oh, so many, I have relatives, I have so many village people, I may be attached with them. So no, if you listen to me, then nothing can do. Kobuna badhibe tomai vishaya taranga, punarupi akthai pabe mautshanga. Guru Maharaj is saying that you don't, when Mahaprabhu is saying, I heard from Guru Maharaj, that kobuna badhibe, if you listen to my order, what is my order? Speak. About Krishna, give Krishna consciousness to others. Maybe in your house, maybe your family, maybe your village, it will be a problem for you. He telling to that Brahmin, you stay in the village. That Brahmin want to go with Mahaprabhu, right? And Mahaprabhu said, no, you stay. Your village, you preach in your village, your country. And then he afraid, oh, there is so many obstacles maybe. He said, no, if you listen to me, if you follow my order, nothing can do. Kobuna badhibe tomai vishaya taranga. Vishaya. Vishaya means, you know, taranga means wave. Wave of vishaya. Material things will not bind you. Because I shall in your back. Kobuna punarupi akthai pabe mohur sangha. I shall in your back. When you are doing this thing, I shall, you will be just like a senapati, mana general, you will go. I shall back you. So, if we, Guru Maharaj is saying, oh, that is what? That is Sankirtana Yoga. If we sacrifice ourselves in Sankirtana Yoga, then it will clean us, it will purify us. Sankirtana Yoga Attahuti. If we throw ourselves in that Sankirtana Yoga, sacrifice fully, then we shall be pure, we shall be clean, just like a gold become clean when we shall put in a fire, right? The Sankirtan, the fire of Sankirtana Yajna only can clean us. Nothing can stop us. I heard from Guru Maharaj that when Bhakti Vichar Jajavan Maharaj was 24 years of age, and he's the last sannyasi of Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur, and Prabhupada wanted to give him sannyas by seeing his dedication, dedicative mood, he wanted to give. But so young, 24 years, then Jajavan Maharaj become afraid, right? Oh, I'm young. Then Prabhupada say, no, you are going to take shelter in the Abhay Pade, mane fearless feet, right? You are taking sannyas means what? You are taking shelter to the fearless Abhay Charan, right? Abhay Charan. Abhay Charan means fearless feet, right? So you are going to take, why? Even the fear afraid of him. Jad Vibheti Swayam Bhayam. Bhagavad saying that Jad Vibheti Swayam Bhayam. Boy, fear, getting fear of that fearless feet, right? So if we take shelter on that feet, fearless feet, Abhay Charanar, therefore Swami Maharaj not left this name. His name is this, right? Abhay Charan. He kept this name because it's so nice, Abhay Charan. It is his previous name. But he not forgotten, he not left, oh, it's my previous name, because the name of the Lord, Abhay Charan, means...
Actually, Prabhupada changed Abhay Charan in Abhay Charanaravinda.
Ah, I see.
His birth name Abhay Charan. Abhay Charan, yeah. Initiation name Abhay Charan Aravinda.
Oh, achha.
You did not know that?
I didn't know.
So when he puts ACs, Abhay Charan Aravinda.
Ah, so nice. So this means that lotus feet, if we take shelter, nothing can do.
Charan Aravinda means Abhay Charan. How you say Abhay Charan Aravinda?
Abhay Charan Ar. Abhaya Charana Arabindare. Because in, yeah, in Bhajahure Mana, song Abhaya Charana Arabinda. Same thing.
Same thing.
For that song, it is here more nice, sounding nice. So in this way, we have to take shelter, but how to take shelter? By the mercy of Vaishnava, we can only know the Lord. Otherwise, I have nothing. When the Vaishnava will show me, when will teach me, then we can have some hope. Otherwise, I have not hope. So when I come this time, Vrindavan, so when Maharaj started a meeting then that day, and I'm also feeling, oh, Maharaj feeling loneliness. So because Maharaj's idea is very good, but communication, lacking some communication. Be Bengali or this Hindi, Vaishnavas, they don't understand what Maharaj really, it is English. So then I'm thinking, if I can get some help. I don't know so much English, you know, you sing. But if I can help, I think, it is also, I can please our Guru Varga by this way to do serve in widely, not in a narrow way, the Vaishnava world. And I'm also happy that our Pujapad Bhakti Vallabh Tirtha Maharaj now is the president. And yesterday,
many years already.
Yes, yesterday some devotee went to Calcutta. I told some devotees, but
the Vishwa Vaishnava Rajshabha magazine,
yes,
both in English and Hindi,
yes,
has been paid by Tirtha Maharaj.
Ah, I see, yes. Yeah, I see, neither seen either day the magazine.
He has said, I want to help. I'm not only giving my name, I give Lakshmi also.
yes, so I'm saying when Maharaj is here, then Tirtha, he is a great personality in this Vaishnava world at present. In India or whole world, we can say. So when Maharaj Srila Bhakti Tirtha Maharaj is there, and when now we have everything, Maharaj not Ori, and well, not Ori, but dance so much I already seen, but I'm still feeling, yeah, if I can do some small Shiva, I shall be happy. And Maharaj gave me that I can, I'm Bengal because I prefer means Godamandal, because I think I when I sing the song, you know all this song, Gaurangera Dutipad, Jara Dhana Sampad, She Jane Bhakati Rasasar. In this song we sing Gaura Prema Rasat, no, Gaura Mandala Bhumi, Jiva Jane Chintamuni, Tar Hai Braja Bhumi Bash, right? So I like this. And Guru Maharaj, sometimes when I'm going some public meeting, Guru Maharaj told, oh, you must sing this song. He's saying, you must sing. Two songs Guru Maharaj always sing us to sing. One is Amana Durmati, Sangsara Bhitare Poriya Achinu Ami, Taboni Jajan, Konu Mahajani, Pathaya Diletumi. This song. And when I going some public meeting in Bengal.
What's first line?
That is Amano Durmati.
Amano Durmati.
It is Guru Maharaj's any meeting, Maharaj is using this song first because it's cover everything. Guru, Vaishnav, Mahaprabhu, everything is there. Krishna, everything.
This is one of the favorite songs of our Guru Maharaj.
Is it?
Yes. Ah. He sings very often, very often.
Yes, it is our song. It is our song.
So, this is one of his favorite songs.
Yes,
in this
maybe
book,
we shall
not
sing.
Here.
Yes, yes, Maharaj, why not?
No.
Amana Durmati Sangsara. Is Saranagati song?
Who is he now?
In Calcutta.
Today he reached Calcutta.
I also heard some devotee went. My god sister.
What is the other song Guru Maharaj wants?
And that go that Gaurangera Duti Pada, Jar Dhana Sampad. So then that song we can sing maybe later. After remembering our Guru Maharaj, we can sing that. So that song, when I read, Gaura Mandala Bhumi, Jiva Jane Chintamani, Tar Hai Braja Bhumi Vas. And Guru Maharaj always, and we are discussing that I am feeling I am very offensive. And when Guru Maharaj is thinking, oh, I am very offensive, maybe Kolodip is good for me. Because it's Aparad Bhanjana part, right? Mahaprabhu given so many people easy way. Mane mercy to all those offensive devotees, offensive. So Guru Maharaj saying, oh, I prefer Kaladev to stay because maybe in this way one day Mahaprabhu will give his mercy or bless me when if I am in Kaladev. So I'm thinking, and then I also am thinking, oh, I cannot approach Mahaprabhu, but if Nityananda Prabhu give me some mercy, then I can approach Mahaprabhu. Then I'm thinking, then so how I can serve Nityananda? And then I desire to our Acharya Dev. So Maharaj, we can do, Guru Maharaj also always saying many things about Nityananda Prabhu. Then if we can serve Nityananda Dham, then so my desire also fulfilled. Now we have a place in Akachakra. If you go anytime, there is some place because I went first, maybe second time with Maharaj, with big group of devotee. That time I and Maharaj went, but we have no place even to sit and mane, nobody is giving some. So in the night when we went from Navadip and morning we reached Ekachakra. Maybe some devotee here is there, I don't know when.
We have been to Ekachakra.
Huh?
We have been to Ekachakra.
Ekachakra, right?
Yes.
No, I'm saying I went with Paramadvaiti Maharaj, my second Ekachakra visit. And many devotees, then we actually not found any place to, proper place to. And those who are taking care of those Vaishnavas in Ekachakra temple, they are not so favorable to us. Sometimes he is favorable with me, but when I go into group saying some Western devotees, they are not so much favorable. Then I am thinking, oh, we need a place when the devotees will come and can stay in Nityananda Dham. Then that desire also fulfilled. We got the Maya mercy of Nityananda Prabhu and Mahaprabhu. We have
that was your Seva Maharaj, no?
I am desired, and Krishna Mani Mahaprabhu are fulfilled. And now we have a four-storied building, maybe 32 rooms.
Four-story Wow.
We have 32 rooms with all attached bathroom. And if any time you go, you can stay there. It is for the devotees who are going to Akachakra Dham. So I'm thinking,
in the middle of Nityananda Mahaprabhu's fortress, one side.
Yes, Bokultala, that place where Nityananda.
It's a mutt over there?
Yes.
What
now,
the
name is Chaitanya Saraswati Mutt.
Yes, Chaitanya Saraswati Krishna Amsana Sangha, Guru Maharaj's name.
Whenever we go for Gaur Purnima, we try to go.
Sure. Now we have a place, you must come. This year, maybe we are making a temple. Guest house we made first. Now we are going to make, already started the temple, already going to finish.
It is ahead of the original Ekachakra Nityananda Prabhu's temple. It is ahead of that.
Yes. If you go there, then
right
little ahead, there is called Bokultala, where Nityananda's child.
Yes, yes.
Near Bokultala, next, right side of the Bokultala.
Right side, yes.
Your one Maharaj, Jachak Maharaj, who was in charge of Guwahati.
Yes,
yes.
He also very like, when I am going there, he also going there. Then I don't know, somewhere, then Bhakti Tirtha Maharaj say, oh, we want a place near the road. He, because Jachak Maharaj want very much, have a place in there. So then Bhakti Mathura said, we want a little inside. Then Bhakti Mathura said, we want a place near the road where our car can easily go, etc. etc. So Jatak Maharaj was also very interested there. I met many times.
He also got place now?
He looking place. But now problem happened. When we went, the price increased 4 times or 5 times more or 10 times more. Now Maharaj little angry Jatak Maharaj with me. we buy because we thought if we have to do fast. It is something, some history is there.
Like when we buy this place,
yes,
in Vrindavan, this whole area price go crazy.
God, yeah. But anyway, then we thought in the Dham place or Vrindavan, we cannot give price for that, right? What price we shall give? So in this way we take. As we
so there's no Thakurji yet?
No,
in Chaitanya Saraswati, no Thakurji?
No, we just worshipping through a picture. I mean, and now this Nityananda Trayodashi, we are hoping we can put deity. Deity already there? Yes. We make a life size Gaur Nityananda. Life size, full size.
6 feet.
Yeah, yeah.
Like in Kalna.
Yes, yes.
Gaur Nityananda, Gauridas Pandit.
Yes, because it's Nityananda Dham. So I'm thinking in this year if we maybe satisfy Nityananda Prabhu, maybe we get the mercy of Mahaprabhu. And then Vrindavan is a very high place. I'm feeling very afraid to be in Vrindavan. But when I see devotees, we have some hope. For service, I'm thinking that Mahaprabhu told Jagadanda not to stay long, right? But he gave Rupa Sanatan, it is your place. I think for the service, we can come Vrindavan. It's not wrong. For the service of Vrindavan, for service of Radharani, we must come. That is not. But I don't know. So I'm feeling always. Then I prefer, maybe Maharaj Gaur Mandal, I can do some Seva. Then Maharaj happily request, means our order. Then I'm happily accepted. This is how?
Nityananda's lotus.
Yeah, Nityananda Prabhu ki jai. Guru Maharaj wrote a very nice slogan of Nityananda. And one day I'm looking that what pranam mantra I offer for Nityananda, right? I'm looking which, then I prefer my Guru Maharaj's anything, right? And that is best for me. Then I'm looking in the Samadhi, Guru Maharaj Samadhi, one shloka written about Nityananda pranam. Then, this is my pranam mantra. And it is so nice. Maybe I cannot explain you. It is in Nityananda Dadashakam, Guru Maharaj's composition. Very nice. If you hear it, it will be very nice, like this. Sri Krishna Premo Nama Parama Sukhamaya Koppa Chinta Padartha Yad Gadha Sajjanogha Nigama Bhumatam Mukshama Pakshipanti Kaivalya Seva Pradagana Iti Jasyangata Premo Datu Srinitvananda Chandram Bhajavaja Satatam Gaura Krishna Pradantam Srinitvananda Chandram Bhajavaja Satatam Gaura Krishna Padantam. Guru Maharaj is saying that I cannot explain so nicely, maybe I can tell. Sri Krishna Premo Nama Parama Sukhamaya Koppa Achinta Padartha Yad Gandhat Sajjanugha Nigama Bhumatam Mukshama Pakshipanti. By hearing Krishna Premo Nama, Sri Krishna Prema Parama Adbhuta Pada Yad Gandhat, by the smell of Krishna Prema, Sajjan means great personality, saints. Nigama Bahumatam, what's the Nigam means Veda, is praising so much about Moksha means Mukti. But they, Pakshipanti, they hating that Mukti. By hearing Krishna Prema Nama, Adhut, some nice things, by the smell of that, who very hating the. What is Nigam? Means Veda saying about, praising about a Mukti, but they hazing. Koivalasya Seva Pradagana Iti Jasyangata Premo Dhatu. And that Prema can be given by Nityananda and by his Anga, by his other part, that Koivalasya Seva we can get. But Premo Dhatu, Nityananda can give us that Prema. Premodata, that is also we can get from him, Gaura Krishna Padamtam. He also can give us Gaura and Krishna. In this way, I cannot explain so much nicely, but I like to this pranam mantra. And in that slok, Guru Maharaj, in the end, he says, Nityananda is Gaurada Potita Saranada. Nityananda can give us Gauranga and his Potita Saranada. Who is Potita? I am Potita. So, he is the shelter of Patita, right? Nityananda is shelter of Patita. Patita Saranada. Mahaprabhu also Patita Saranada, but Nityananda is more, right? Then I'm thinking, I'm Patita. I'm so much sinful. First I may try to serve Nityananda Prabhu. Then maybe vice mercy. And when we heard this song, Nitayer Koruna Habe, Bruje Ratha Krishna Pabe, Dharo Nitayari Charano Dukhani. Then I'm thinking, oh, I can do some Shiva in Gaura Mandal. And Maharaj actually given. So I'm actually happy. I don't know, I'm no money qualification to do the Shiva, but I'm happy when anyone do Gaura Mandal Parikrama. And last time somebody says, then I said, you must come to Akachakra and stay here. And at least I can do some Shiva. And in this way, I think we can fulfill the desire of our Guru Varga and Lord, if we love in their dham, their place, that way, and their preach their conception, their manovishta. Gurudev's manovishta what? We become Krishna consciousness. That is the manovishta. There is a desire of Gurudev not wants anything from me. He wants actually I become fully dedicated, fully serve Krishna. That is we want. So I'm also praying from you, please bless me, give me mercy that I can do some Seva to Guru Vaishnav. And I think this way we can give our Seva to Mahaprabhu and Radha Govinda. Without serving Guru Vaishnav, there is no hope that you can serve Krishna. It is a very difficult job. Our line is that we are not going directly serving, right? We heard so much, I don't realize so much, but that our line is Rupanuga, right? We are going through channel, we cannot worship directly Lalita Devi or Radharani. Our Guru Varga, we can offer some, and that will be the best way to satisfy Krishna. I can offer directly, it will not go. It will not reach even. It will not take care. But if I send through this channel, So our Guru Parampara and Vaishnava Brinda, then maybe one day it will reach to Radharani and then it will satisfy Krishna. And so I praying to you. Maharaj may say something more.
Yes, I request you,
yes,
in the spirit of what you are speaking, mm-hmm, to write a little booklet.
Mm.
Number one subject is what you're talking about, Nityananda.
Yes.
Number two subject is this favorite songs of Guru Maharaj.
Yes, sure.
Number three subject, the vision of Guru Maharaj and Vishwa Vaishnava Chapa.
Yes, yes.
And this small booklet, yes, I requesting from you both in English and Bengali.
Okay. Yes.
When you finish the English,
yes,
you can send to me. I will get somebody to edit it,
yes,
to make,
yes,
good polished.
Yes, yes, sir.
Because actually, yes, actually, we were missing over the last years after Guru Maharaj's departure.
Yes.
We were missing some more Guru Maharaj nectar,
mm-hmm,
from somebody who was there,
mm-hmm,
who felt and saw,
mm-hmm,
and it was not covered by some kind of other agenda.
Mm-hmm.
Actually, Guru Maharaj's heritage,
yes, yes,
was that even at the risk,
yes,
he decided to help the disciples of Swami Maharaj.
Yes, yes, yes.
I was personally there,
mm-hmm,
when Guru Maharaj got two letters.
Yes, yes.
One letter said, if you give sannyas to, mm, this guy,
mm,
me,
mm,
if you accept him,
yes,
you will be in trouble.
I see.
We will put you in trouble.
Trouble, yes.
At that time,
mm,
separate from that,
mm,
there was actually a plan to put a bomb,
mm-hmm,
in Chaitanya Saraswat,
yes,
Mat.
Yes, yes.
And the one who was offered money to put the bomb,
yes, yes,
he came to Guru Maharaj,
yes,
said,
and told everything.
I will not do such a thing.
Yes.
I want to warn you.
Yes.
So actually our Guru Maharaj, something nobody knows.
Yes.
These facts of history, yes, nobody knows, mm, in the whole world, maybe a few handful.
Mm-hmm.
So Guru Maharaj, he took this into his heart to help the Western devotees. That's confirmed.
Huh? Confirmed.
Because if you look at the history does not always look good for everybody.
Yes.
That's why we sometimes in the history we try to be quiet,
yes,
about certain elements of history. Like Swami Maharaj, Prabhupada,
mm-hmm,
when he first came to India, not everybody was so happy and so appreciative.
Yes, yes.
Some of his Guru Bhai said to him, what is this? Who is this man coming with? Now, in excuse to them, we may say, well, some of the Western devotees who Swami Prabhupada brought to India, they later did very bad things. So the fear which came from some of the Gaudiya sannyasis was not totally unfounded, that, oh, they may also create problems. At that time, Swami Maharaj wanted to buy land in Mayapur.
Yes.
And some of the Gaudiya Mats tried to stop it. They said, no, we don't want these Westerners here. There was ISKCON had no land there. So Swami Maharaj was very sad. And he went to Srila Sridhar Maharaj. Another story. People just don't know the history. But we can write it down and bring a new focus into this, because we both have both love for Swami Maharaj Prabhupada and for Sridhar Maharaj, because we know the real history. So then Sridhar Maharaj, he told his Guru Bhai, stop it.
Yes.
Don't make politics.
Yes.
Let him buy land there. So then they agreed. Okay.
Yes.
Okay. If Sridhar Maharaj says, he was the unwritten authority.
Yes.
He was unwritten because he never wanted. Because when he saw that there was politics about management, money and power, Sridhar Maharaj said, not with me. I'm going to my Koladanga, doing my bhajan, and leave me alone.
Yes.
But when they asked him advice, he always gave. And in this case, he intervened, says, stop making politics, let Prabhupada have land. So that's the beginning of ISKCON. ISKCON doesn't recognize that they got that land by the help of Sridhar Maharaj. Anyhow, it's a separate story. Even Goswami Maharaj got his land by the grace of Srila Sridhar Maharaj. Do you know that story?
No.
Nobody knows any story. That is funny. Goswami Maharaj, he was another very sensitive man.
Yes.
He was from Nityananda Vamsa.
Yes.
So he was the pride of Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur. Because if a Nityananda Goswami man surrenders to Gaudiya Math, that is like when Srila Sridhar Maharaj, he was a local Brahmin, when he surrendered, or when Krishnamayi Didi, a local Brahmin lady, surrendered to Gaudiya Math, that was just a few years after those Brahmins threw stones at Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur. So that history has to be brought out into the truth today. So of course they were proud that finally one of those leading prestigious Brahmins has actually surrendered. So Goswami Maharaj was also one of these very sensitive devotees. So what happened? When the Gaudiya Math was starting to fight about Ananta Vasudev, then Goswami Maharaj, he had already started his preaching mission, but he said, I am not going to step a foot in Mayapur because they're fighting there. I don't want to be there. Then Srila Sridhar Maharaj said, no, our Guru Maharaj's disciples, like you, have to be in Mayapur to purify and to establish the true line of Bhakti Siddhanta. Because at that time, this fighting also Sridhar Maharaj did not like.
Yes.
The Goswami Maharaj said, no. Then Sridhar Maharaj went and with his own money or some Lakshmi of some supporter, he bought a piece of land. And he sent the documents, the paper to Goswami Maharaj. Now you have land.
Yes.
Then Goswami Maharaj, because Sridhar Maharaj is Goswami Maharaj's sannyas guru. So then Goswami Maharaj said, well, if Guru Maharaj says like this, he give me land. I mean, your guru gives you the land here. So he said, okay, I accept. I make mat there. So then he went there and he said, okay, make a little temple here, make this. Then Sridhar Maharaj went there when they were starting construct. And he asked, so what are you making here? And I said, we have a little temple here, little house here. Sridhar Maharaj looked at the plan. He said, no.
No.
He took his cane and he painted on the ground. He scratched the ground. Here's Nat Mandir. Here's Thakurji Mandir. Here's guest house. When they went and they told Goswami Maharaj what Sridhar Maharaj had done, immediately construct like he did. So this is a relationship, very sensitive, very intimate. Mm-hmm. So Swami Maharaj was right next to Goswami Maharaj.
Yes,
yes. So therefore, Sridhar Maharaj had authority, especially in Ishodhyan. So this was one history. Then Sridhar Maharaj, he took this when Swami Maharaj's disciples were in trouble because ISKCON was going through turmoil. The first gurus of ISKCON started falling down and some devotees did not know what to do. He said, I have to help. Even though he was criticized for that from many sides, because you have to understand one thing, at that time there was not one face, white face, in Chaitanya Math or in Gaudiya Mission, the two big Gaudiya organizations. Nor in Keshava Maharaj's Math, nor in Madhava Maharaj's Math, not one white face. It was like a different planet, a different race. Like we look at... we have never seen a Chinese devotee before. But now Chinese devotees also exist.
Yes.
People say, what? Chinese? And Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna? Yes. What is happening? Nobody has conquered the Chinese in thousands of years being next to China.
Yes.
They have not become Hindus.
Yes.
They have become Buddhists, they have become this and that, but not Hindus. Now they're becoming Hindus. Chinese can also become devotee?
Yeah.
You mean Chinese can also be sadhu? So you have to digest it because you are not accustomed to this. No. So at that time in Gaudiya Math, no white face. But not only no white face, also no belief that white face can be also become bhakta. There's one story. Some people don't like it so much, but I tell it to you for your enlightenment. I don't even know if Tirtha Maharaj knows this story. It's a very special story. When Swami Maharaj invited his Guru Bhais one day to Mayapur, they all came, they sat with him, and after sitting with him, then Swami Maharaj said, okay, now we have prasadam for all of you. Then the God brothers, they talked, when they sat down, and they said, this has been cooked by the white guys. They have not good samskar. So maybe their food is not so paka. So they took the prasadam in the plate and put in the bushes.
Mm-hmm.
Not eat. Mm-hmm. And go. When Swami Maharaj hear that, very sad. My Guru Bhai don't accept my service. They think what we are doing is some kind of imitation. But not real bhakti, not real prasadam, not real. One time, one person came to my temple, I won't say names. That person was associated with one Gaudiya Math and came to our temple in Berlin. And when we invited for prasadam, the person said to the devotee, don't eat this. This is not prasadam. If you want to eat, first you have to offer the prasadam to your guru in your mind. Mm. Then you can eat. When I hear this, I say, oh God, what kind of conception? It is immature. Anyhow, so something like this happened. So Swami Maharaj was very sad. Then one of those devotees was Srila Bhakti Pramod Puri Maharaj, my Shiksha Guru. So he sent a letter to Swami Maharaj when he was given the Kalna Mandir of Ananta Vasudev. He was given that mat because Kalna King, he liked Gaudiya Math, he liked Puri Math, but he did not have anybody to look after this temple, Bhaka. So Puri Maharaj wrote a letter to Swami Maharaj, can you please give me some Lakshmi to help fixing this temple? You know that story? Swami Maharaj answered a letter, says, dear Puri Maharaj, I could give some money, but I have some problem that this Lakshmi is all coming from these mlechas. So it is contaminated Lakshmi. And you are a Paka pure Brahmin. If I give to you, then you will become contaminated. He wrote a letter like this, like chastising his Guru Bhai. Guru Bhai can chastise Guru Bhai. Otherwise not, we don't chastise our Guru Varga. But Guru Bhai can do that. It's no problem, no? So he said, but if you want me to manage the money, mandir, and make it nice, I can do so. Anyhow, quiet. Swami Maharaj did not give any money, and Puri Maharaj did not write again. 1977. This story was told to us by Puri Maharaj himself. This story is not coming from other side, from gossip side. It's coming from the mouth of Puri Maharaj. That time, Puri Maharaj came to Swami Maharaj because Swami Maharaj was leaving the world. And Puri Maharaj said, oh, excuse all the offenses. And Swami Maharaj said, no, no offenses. Swami Maharaj said, forgive all my offenses, the other way around. And Puri Maharaj said, no, no offenses, only some little friction in the beginning, you try to do something. Anyhow, that was very nice. Then Swami Maharaj asked Puri Maharaj, can you give me a gift? And Puri Maharaj says, yes, yes, what can I give you? Please sing from me the song Sri Rupa Manjari Pata. Because when our Gurudev passed away, you were singing, but Sridhar Maharaj continued song. Now I want to hear from you. So Srila Puri Maharaj sang Sri Rupa Manjari Pada and a few other songs because he has a very sweet voice. He was one of the greatest bhajaniyas in the Gaudiya Math. So he sang this song and Swami Maharaj was listening in his bed, very happy. Then some time went on. Then Swami Maharaj asked, Puri Maharaj, can I also give you a gift? And Puri Maharaj said, what you like, of course. So then Swami Maharaj said, bring a big plate of Mahaprasadam from Krishna Balaram. So they brought the big plate of Mahaprasadam, put to Puri Maharaj, and water and everything. He took water, he took the whole prasad, and then, la la la, finished the meeting, Puri Maharaj goes. Then Puri Maharaj says, what was the gift he gave me? In Gaudiya Math, to give somebody plate of eat some prasadam when he visits you, that's not considered a gift. Huh? This is normal. Everybody. How can a rich man like Swami Maharaj, he was very rich at that time, the mission was very big, he asked Puri Maharaj, can I give you a gift? And then he gives him prasadam. Mm-hmm. What kind of a gift is that? And then Puri Maharaj said, all of a sudden he understood what the gift was. That he had been chanting this mantra for almost 80 years at that time. And he had not understood that this mantra can turn a mlecha into a Vaishnava. This is how powerful the Mahamantra is. Yeah. This is how powerful the Sankirtan movement is. And he had not fully realized that. And that was the gift Swami Maharaj gave to his Guru Bhai. This mantra you are chanting all your life is the topmost Maha Mantra, mercy mantra, prema mantra of all. And it can change anybody, even a criminal, into a real Vaishnava. So then Puri Maharaj said, this moment changed my life. He said, from that moment on, I started accepting Westerners as devotees. From that moment on. Not only that, but he initiated Westerners. He gave sannyas to Westerners. Yeah. Who in the Gaudiya Math has given sannyas to Westerners? Only Swami Maharaj, Sridhar Maharaj, Puri Maharaj, and I think Tirtha Maharaj has given, I'm not sure, Tirtha Maharaj has Western sannyasi?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Who?
One Narsimha Maharaj.
Russian?
But now he's no more.
Yes.
One Russian, no?
Yeah, Russian.
Right, so Sridhar, Tirtha Maharaj also, but from the disciples of Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati, only the three. Bodhain Maharaj, yes, now this is second generation, no? And the Rhine Maharaj also later, but in that time. So it was a strange thing to give sannyas to a Westerner. But Puri Maharaj, our orthodoxy, you can say Puri Maharaj was the personification of rules and regulations and orthodoxy of the Gaudiya Math. That's why he installed all the deities in the Gaudiya Math, because he knew how to do that and he was strict, follow the highest principles. So he started accepting. Now, many times when I was with Puri Maharaj, because I associated with him the last years of his life, his mission was just starting. He started his mission, maybe he was 90 years old something.
Yes, yes.
So he, because he was always helping Madhava Maharaj.
Yes.
Many times he come to me and he take me on my Uttariya like this. He pull me over, he says, Baba, Baba, we are all equals. He said many times, I don't understand, what is he trying to say to me? Why is he pulling me like this and saying we are all equals? Because I know I'm not an equal of his. Mm-hmm. He's my Guru Varga, he's my Shiksha Guru. But why is he doing this? Why is he saying we are all equals? Mm-hmm. And he was thinking about this thing, that we all have the same chance. If we take shelter of Guru and we become Guru, because the order of Mahaprabhu to all is to become Guru, like we were discussing yesterday. It is the order. He also again quoted it, Kurma situation. So everybody has the same chance if he chants the Mahamantra and takes shelter of Sadhu Sangha and a Guru. So Puri Maharaj never told me that story. No, but he said that we are all equal, and I try to understand what is he trying to say. He also told me in one of those occasions, take care of the education, that the education of the Vaishnavas is well prepared. He also said that, but anyhow, but just before Srila Puri Maharaj left the world, maybe a few months before, one of my god sisters, Mula Prakriti, she was making interviews with different people who still knew, had seen Swami Maharaj. So she also went to Purimaj. At that time, Purimaj was not receiving visitor anymore. He was not giving classes. But when he heard that one of Swami Maharaj Shishya wants an interview about Swami Maharaj, he said, yes, I want to give this interview. And in this interview, this last interview, he told this story. He told the story of the gift of Swami Maharaj to him. In other words, he revealed, because in one sense you may say it's embarrassing that you only realize at the eight, when you're 80 years old, that the Mahamantra can transform. But it's kind of a power thing. It's a different time and places reveal different features.
Yes.
So this was to be revealed. So then Puri Maharaj told that story, and Mula Prakriti, she recorded it and she put it in that book of Prabhupada, the Friend of All, which he published. So I heard the story there, and I started understanding everything when I heard that story. Everything went like, aha, this is what happened. That's why Puri Maharaj was so close to me, so friendly, so intimate. Because you go and meet an old sannyasi, doesn't mean immediately he coming and take you in the room and let's sit down and talk to you, no? Not everybody's like that. Most people are a little bit, yes, what you need, what you want. Different relationship, no? No? So, this is a little bit of the history of the importance of East and West coming together to work. Because in ISKCON, there's Eastern and Western devotees, but neither of them except the Indian devotees of the Gaudiya Math. Very strange. It's another type of phenomena. It's a phenomena of institutional pride. Sometimes you are proud of your body. I'm born in Brahmin family. This is a pride. Smart. Another pride is I was born in India. Another type of pride. Another type of pride is I belong to the institution which saved the world. Nobody else saved the world. So any type of pride is not good for spiritual life. It actually brings you down. It actually makes you somehow ridiculous. So that therefore in ISKCON you have ISKCON, of course not everybody. There's some open-minded, lovely devotees, but the Indian devotees in ISKCON and the Western devotees in ISKCON, they're like a special clan. They never come to a Gaudiya Math festival. They never offer their obeisances to Madhava Maharaj, Sridhar Maharaj. They all say, no, Gaudiya Math, Gaudiya Math, Gaudiya Math. This is the strange Gaudiya Math. Huh? And that's what they teach the new devotees in ISKCON. They're actually misguiding the young devotees who come to that mission by teaching them to see with discrimination, which is no Vaishnava discrimination, to their young people. And we have to help them to stop this. Because by doing so, they are damaging their own future. But this is not the only problem. The world of Maya is full of problems. Yes, yes. But these are all problems the Vishva Vaishnava Ratshaba has addressed. That is why Srila Jiva Goswami wanted this. Because not everybody who took initiation from Rupa and Sanatana Goswamis were Brahmins. Narottam Das Thakur was from a Kayasta family, from a King Kayasta family, and his initiation as a guru was questioned and it was attacked. Yes. Even at the time 300 years ago. So they already had the same problems. It's not something new.
Yes.
And not every devotee in Bengal has full appreciation for the devotees of Orissa or for the devotees of Punjab.
Mm-hmm.
No, they sing a little different, they dance a little different,
mm-hmm.
so they are different.
Mm-hmm.
But this is only styles, this is not different. If you are surrendered to Guru,
yes.
it doesn't matter if your style is a little different.
Mm-hmm.
We cannot sing, oh, if you don't eat in a big mountain of rice like this, then you're not Gaudiya Vaishnava. I mean, this is not true, because the Hindi Vaishnavas, they eat chapati. Huh? So it's a different style. And when you go to South India and they convert to Gaudiya Vaishnavism, they will still eat dosha in idli.
Yes.
I guarantee you.
Yes. Yes.
So though then somebody comes and say, no dosha and idli here, so there cannot be Vaishnavas.
Mm.
This is like the external illusion type of thing.
Yes, yes.
So Puri Maharaj was one of those persons who realized that by the grace of Swami Maharaj, and he showed the example to the other devotees how things should be different. And the relationship between East and West has to be a real spiritual cooperation for saving the world and for doing things different. But even some of his own disciples rejected Srila Puri Maharaj for taking that attitude.
Mm.
Not Bodhayan Maharaj. Bodhayan Maharaj accepted it, and he's now an international preacher because of that.
Yes.
Because he has this qualification.
Yes.
So this is, oh, I forgot, Srila Bhakti Vaibhav Puri Maharaj also gave sannyas to Westerners.
Yes.
We forgot one here.
Yes.
So, but in many of the Gaudiya Maths, even until today, you don't see one white face. And when they see white faces, they become afraid. This is, what is this? White face? Can it be true? And okay, see a white face who gives you a donation, that's okay. That white face you can tolerate. But a white face who is a sannyasi, who is a guru, who has a mission, oh no, they cannot digest that. They say this must be something wrong. But it's not wrong. It's the kripa of Mahaprabhu.
Yes.
It is the kripa and the power of the holy name of Krishna.
Yes.
And this topic, this subject, can only be explained by somebody like Tirtha Maharaj, who has seen it with his eyes.
Yes.
Because when Sridhar Maharaj accepted us,
yes.
when he accepted us, he was criticized,
yes.
he was threatened,
yes.
and he said, does not matter. Like in my case, particular case, he got these heavy letters, and many of the devotees of the Mat told him, do not accept Paramadvaiti, because this will give trouble to us. Srila Sridhar Maharaj's conclusion was, they just write letters, but he came here,
wow.
he is here, mm. physically, personally,
yes.
so I will accept.
Wow. That Ramchandra told to about Vibhishan, right? They're afraid, oh, Vibhishan may be something, but say, no, who took shelter? I have to give him shelter. Wanted to say, nothing stopped me, Ramchandra.
Hey, this is not, thank you for this example. It sounds
in
very charming. Yes, and when I came to Srila Sridhar Maharaj, because I had come out of a struggle situation there in ISKCON, the first thing he said, oh, Paramadvaiti, a bold preacher, he said, oh, you are not fearful to go with the truth. And that's why you give up this institution to stay with the true sadhu.
Yes.
And the true sadhu is more important than any institution.
Yeah.
That's another lesson we have to learn, even though it's very painful to leave an institution. And that's another story I wanted to tell you, Maharaj. After we left ISKCON, we found shelter at the feet of Srila Bhakti Rakakshita Maharaj. But even then, Srila Sridhar Maharaj did not want to take responsibility for all the temples in South America.
Yes, yes.
As a matter of fact, I was 4 years with Srila Sridhar Maharaj. 4 years sitting at his feet. He never even asked me how many temples you have, how many devotees are there, nothing. He never asked that.
Yes, yes.
He could have asked me 100 times, no?
No?
He never asked that, he just said. So I could understand that all the devotees from South America, they cannot come to take shelter of Srila Sridhar Maharaj. They don't have money for that. They don't speak the language. It will not be a practical thing. So even in the beginning of Srila Sridhar Maharaj's mission, he accepted an entire mission in his mission. So because he accepted that, I came sometimes with 30 devotees there, not only alone. So Guru Maharaj was one of the very rare people who can be a guru of other gurus and make everybody feel harmonized. He had no problem to harmonize with them. So after Guru Maharaj left, I still kept coming like normal, but the new generation of devotees, they were not on that level, and they could not tolerate that this man is coming, he has his independent missions. So I was given the feeling, Maharaj knows that, not to be at home anymore, not to be welcomed. Even though I was giving big donations, not huge, but big donations, no? So, but even the big donations were not enough, because they were feeling, if you don't surrender fully, then you're not with us. Like, you are with me or against me. But this is not really. So then I had to withdraw from that environment, and I lost my spiritual family for a second time. Where I had taken shelter, where I had preached to my disciples. So I was thinking, this whole thing is crazy. What am I gonna tell the devotees in South America? You are rejected by ISKCON. You are rejected by Gaudiya Math. You are now rejected by Chaitanya Saraswat Math also. So I said, what is this? Is this a movement of accepting and embracing, or is this a movement of rejecting and throwing out? So then I was very, very unhappy, because how do I explain that to my family, my family members? How can I explain this? What's going on in India? So then I started studying, and I found the information of Jiva Goswami, Vishva Vaishnava Rajshabha. I started looking, what did Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur really want to do? Then I found one shloka in Sridhar Maharaj's Sujana Buddha Radita Pada Yugam, where he said, you started a beautiful association of pure devotees in Vrindavan. And I could see our real philosophy is not institution consciousness, it is the plurality of divine mercy. And that's what Srila Sridhar Maharaj explained so clear and so perfectly in Sri Guru and His Grace. So then I could understand something is wrong. And we have to make it right. So that any Vaishnava in the world, today, tomorrow, in 100 years, in 500 years, can say, we belong to the tree of Mahaprabhu. We belong to the conception given by the greatest philosopher of all, Srila Jiva Goswami, that we follow the principles of unity in diversity, because the guru-disciple relationship is a very intimate relationship. Even that doesn't belong into an institution. Like when I took Harinam and Diksha from my Gurudev Srila Prabhupada, I never knew I was becoming a member of an institution. I never signed a paper. I was never handed, here are the bylaws, please read them, because you're just entering the area of an institutional commitment. No. I just, here's your japa and chant Hare Krishna and follow the essence of the truth. You're becoming initiated by a true devotee of the truth. That was my connection. So that connection, guru-disciple, is very private. Srila Sridhar Maharaj said, guru and disciple, they must have a private area where nobody comes and disturbs. He said that very clearly. Otherwise, the guru-disciple relationship cannot function properly. So in this way, he provided that, or Krishna provides this. This is the type of relationship which is necessary. So then, by the grace of Srila Puri Maharaj, who actually started the Vishva Vaishnava Ratchaba, I went to him, I said, Guru Maharaj, we have to change this. We have to create something. And this is Prabhupada's line. And then something happened. Actually, I didn't say to him, let's start the Vishva Vaishnava Ratchaba. I told him, let's start the World Vaishnava Association. Let's provide a platform where everybody can be at home without having an institutional grip, tie, control. No, just heart to heart, appreciation, sadhu sangha. Like when we all sit in a big Vaishnava meeting, sannyasis coming from everywhere. There's no institutional tie. There's only appreciation. We follow the same essence. So then Puri Maharaj accepted it, and he became the first president of the World Vaishnava Association. After 2 years of running the World Vaishnava Association, we had a meeting in Mayapur, in Srivas Anga. And Bhakti Niloy Giri Maharaj, one of the disciples of Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur, he came to this meeting and he pulled out a magazine. That was an old Gaudiya magazine. And he read from this magazine what we've been reading in Jai Sri. He wrote everything which was said about the Vishva Vaishnava Ratchaba. Then Giri Maharaj say, I can see what you're doing here. This is what Prabhupada was trying to do. Therefore, I name this the Vishva Vaishnava Ratchaba again. So by a disciple of Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur, the World Vaishnava Association gained the old name of Vishva Vaishnava Ratchaba. And Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur, when he visited the Maharaj of Mysore, in the library of the Maharaj of Mysore, there's a guest book. And he was asked to sign the guest book. And he wrote, Vishva Vaishnava Raj Shabha Patra Raj Bhakti Siddhanta. He signed as a representative of Vishva Vaishnava Raj Shabha. He didn't sign Gaudiya Mission, Gaudiya Mat.
Right.
So this is how the things come together. This is how the different bits and pieces come together, and to show that actually by the grace of Srila Bhakti Pramod Puri Maharaj, and by the grace, the first thing Srila Puri Maharaj told me, he said, if you want somebody to help you with this, then you go and talk to Bhakti Balab Tirtha Maharaj, who at that time was already Acharya of Chaitanya Gaudiya Math, but Puri Maharaj said, he will help you. And by the will of Puri Maharaj, and that's also Sri Tirtha Maharaj accepted to be the next president and became an active supporter. So this is the history, and that's why I'm requesting our Bhakti Prapana Tirtha Maharaj, because he has been a witness of all the things I'm saying here, to let us write it down from the history of what happened with our dear Srila Sridhar Maharaj and how he was sticking out his head for Vaishnava unity.
Right.
And Sridhar Maharaj used to say, I give you connection, but go back and do your seva in ISKCON. He did not want to steal man from ISKCON.
I know that.
Not like some other conflicts later became like a big stealing man here and there and a big battle everywhere. But ISKCON told the man, if you went to Sridhar Maharaj, we don't want you here anymore. Out. Mm-hmm. There was a famous saying in that point, you cross the river, you can't come back. If you crossed the river to Navadvip, you were not allowed back in Mayapur.
Yes, yes.
This is some, it's not the whole history. Whole history is much longer, but you have heard some of it. So remember it and tell it others when you see that they're in this illusion of Orissa devotees or Maharashtra devotees or no. It's only Gauranga Mahaprabhu's devotees.
Yes.
Everything else is Maya.
Yes.
And if we look at them in any, we have any filter in front of our eyes.
Mm.
Or just like we say male devotee, female devotee.
Yes.
If devotee is devotee, Vaishnava or Vaishnavi, apparat is the same.
Yes.
So, so don't fall into this trap, then you can serve your guru much better, much sweeter, everything will become harmonizing. And last not least, by the grace of Srila Puri Maharaj, our devotees in South America now, they feel we belong to Mahaprabhu's mission. Because there is such a thing.
Great person.
But of course, when they come to India to an actual meeting, they see none is participating from the only Indian section, then they feel what? They don't understand this?
Yeah.
They cannot understand the message of Mahaprabhu. How is possible? Of course, then they meet Tirtha Maharaj, and they meet our Bhakti Balab Tirtha Maharaj, and they meet Bodhain Maharaj, and they can understand, no. But on the whole, we have a lot of work to do.
Yes.
Even amongst our own selves, do not discriminate against each other, but to help each other.
Really?
To help each other so that Mumbai will be filled with happy Gaudiya Vaishnavas.
Yes.
And Chennai as well, and everywhere in the world. And it all depends on the personal relationship, because what makes Krishna conscious work is that people have love and trust.
Right.
Only by love and trust in a Vaishnava. One last anecdote, you know that. One disciple of Swami Maharaj, Yasomati Nandan, the chief of Gujarat ISKCON, he was sent to interview Srila Sridhar Maharaj on behalf of the GBC if they could not make some peace with him, like political peace. So, because the ISKCON was also disturbed by this, no? So then, Yasomati Nandan said to Srila Sridhar Maharaj, well, our devotees, they are not happy that some of our ISKCON men are coming to you, and they want to see if you cannot accept the working relationship with ISKCON. Then Srila Sridhar Maharaj says, I cannot be under any institutional restriction. This is not going. My consciousness is a free consciousness.
Yes.
Then the devotee said, but we have to keep the form. We have to keep it something. Says, the form? He said, I am a form breaker. I am not a form maker. I'm the searching for the essence. I'm searching for the divine. And Krishna himself, he said, he is a form breaker, yes, not a form maker. Krishna speaks about dharma, and then he says, sarva dharma parichaja, get rid of the form and come to me. Yeah. It's not that you become attached to karma, kanda, jnana, kanda. No, sharanagati, give it all up and come to me. So he said, Krishna is a form breaker, not a form maker, and I'm also. So this devotee wrote down everything, but he didn't understand anything. So he went back to ISKCON and said, Sridhar Maharaj said he wants to break the form of ISKCON. Then in all of ISKCON it was spread. Careful, careful. Don't go to this man who wants to break the mission of Prabhupada. Of course, they didn't say he wants to break some institutional limitation. No, they said he wants to break the mission of our Gurudev. So what does a normal ISKCON man feels if anybody tells him another person wants to break the institution of my guru? And he goes, come here, I'll get you. Nobody's gonna break the mission of my guru, right? So by this misinterpretation of Mr. Yasomati Nandan, the ISKCON movement was taught that Sridhar Maharaj wants to break ISKCON. And of course, that's the way they stopped many devotees from going to get his grace.
Yes.
That's history. And I can vouch for it, like in the court of law. This is truth and nothing but the truth. It's not manipulated, and it doesn't. I don't speak it for any particular purpose except for serving the truth.
Yeah.
Yeah, so, is this transcription in the search for purity?
Yes, some part of it, maybe not so extensive and flowery like I put it out, because Tirtha Maharaj inspiring me. Of course, he knows all these things, but still from every angle, like from my angle, things looked different. I mean, Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, he was chosen. Oh, there's one more beautiful point of Srila Sridhar Maharaj. One person asked to Srila Sridhar Maharaj, why did Rupa Goswami write these books? And why did Jiva Goswami write these books?
Yes.
And why this and why that? Why one discovered holy places, the other not? Then Srila Sridhar Maharaj became almost angry and he says, do not think that any service done by any Goswami could not have been done by the others. Do not think that way. So Bhakti Daita Madhavamaj did his service. Bhakti Sharanga Goswami did his service. Bhakti Vilas Tirtha Maharaj did his service. Bhakti Vedanta Swami Prabhupada did his service. Why did they do the service? By the grace of Mahaprabhu. And each and everyone could have also been chosen different, if Mahaprabhu wishes so. But he didn't wish so, he wished it this way. And Jajava Maharaj, this is one of the most amazing things, which also shows the realizations. Jajava Maharaj was talking about him today, last sannyasi of who took sannyas with 24 years. He said, when he came to Krishna Balaram, he was invited to one of Prabhupada's disappearance festivals, maybe 2 years or 3 years after Prabhupada. He said, my opinion, he said, and I can only say this, my opinion, what Swami Maharaj did is not a common human feat. It's not. A normal human being could not have done so. it's beyond. Therefore, I accept Swami Maharaj as a Shakti Avesha avatar of Lord Krishna's preaching potency, of taking it everywhere on the planet. In ISKCON, nobody would ever have dared to call Bhaktivedanta Swami Maharaj a Shakti Avesha avatar, because, well, every disciple will say, my guru is also Shakti Avesha avatar. Mm. Why he?
Mm-hmm.
Like it becomes a competition, a title competition. Who has more Srila, Srimad, Sridhar, and all whatever in the title? No. This Shakti Avesha was given as a recognition of the feeling by Judge Ramaj. Of course, ISKCON embraced it happily, because, I mean, if my Gurudev is a Shakti Avesha avatar recognized, this is like, wow, my God, it makes my heart real warm. But when they asked Sridhar Maharaj about it, that's what Jajava Maharaj said. Sridhar Maharaj thought about it and he said, I can only agree with him. I think Swami Maharaj has been a Shakti Avesha avatar of Nityananda's mercy.
Yes.
Which is the same, no? Because this is what he did. And by the way, in Gaudiya Math, very rarely they worship Gonitai. But Swami Maharaj put Gonitai all over the world.
Yes.
So somebody, Nityananda, decided to go in the front by choosing Swami Maharaj, Prabhupada, to be the instrument of that.
Yes.
So before they were worshipping more Gogadada.
Yes.
It is then only Goswami Maharaj in Nandanacharya Bhavan.
Yes.
He was worshipping Gonitai because that was the place where Gonitai met. And here in Vrindavan, Gonitai was in Sanatan Goswami and in Sringavat.
Yes.
These were the three important places in our Sampradaya of Gonitai. Otherwise not. So that Sridhar Maharaj's confirmation of Jajavar Maharaj, that really became the authority to say, and now look at this. In Gaudiya Math, if you say Prabhupada, they think Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur Prabhupada. They don't think Swami Maharaj. For his disciples, of course, he's Prabhupada, because that's how we call him all our life. But in Gaudiya Math, not. But listen, nobody in Gaudiya Math has proposed that Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur Prabhupada is a Shakti Avesha avatar. That nobody has ever mentioned that. In other words, Jajava Maharaj and Sridhar Maharaj gave a title or a recognition to Swami Maharaj superior to his own guru. Fortunately, Swami Maharaj is not there, because he would never have tolerated that anybody give him a title superior to his guru. He would go, no. But impartially speaking, this is what happened, and ISKCON doesn't recognize it. They forget this. They call Swami Maharaj a Shakti Avesha avatar, but they don't know where it comes from, how it came, who could ever say such a thing. They forgot who gave the recognition to their own guru. And if you don't recognize the one who recognizes your guru, your recognition is bogus.
Yes.
It's like if you don't recognize the university who gave the title to the guy, then the title is bogus. Right? What's the use of a title if it's being given by the pun seller on the corner? So there is lots of work to get a little bit of energy and get people having a larger understanding, because you see, the devotees in India, in the Gaudiya Math, they have a great power. If Krishna wants, they can go all over the world again and again and making much more Krishna consciousness. Why? Prithiviti achayate nagaradigram, that is not yet fulfilled. and it will not be fulfilled by one institution. Those institutions who think, or the people of institutions who think that the institutions will save the world, they're wrong. If anybody gonna save anybody in the world, it's gonna be the true sadhus.
Yes.
Not the institutions.
Guru Maharaj say, society conscious or Krishna conscious?
Yes. Anyhow.
Nice.
This was a very, very nice reflection this morning on all the history of Vishwa Vaishnava Rajshabha. And its practical application to our problems today.
Yeah.
Because we still have problems.
Yes.
Would be nice to say we don't have any problems. There are still.
Actually, by God's grace, actually we in Bombay, we don't think that concept. We are from God, we go to everywhere. Even to Bhakti Pramod Puri Gaudiamath, even to Sridhar Maharaj, even to ISKCON, we don't go as per that. No, we are from only God. Chaitanya, we should not go in there. We accept everything.
We've been given this understanding to extract the essence.
But this is coming from your Gurudev Srila Bhakti Ballabh Tirtha Maharaj.
Yes.
Because he doesn't have that.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
You are depending on your Guru's grace, and he is this open.
Yes, because of Guru Maharaj's mercy only, he has this understanding.
Yes, that is true. You see, he has a very intimate relationship with us, so you don't feel afraid to come here and listen to a class.
Yes.
And also you are what you may call Mumbai, Chennai, they're metropoles of so much culture mixing that actually you know by it cannot be in a different way. You get some problems from the big city and some benefits also. So when you become the metropolitan preachers of the great truths of Mahaprabhu, that will be another power.
Mm-hmm.
So Mahaprabhu is preparing everybody. So if anybody of you become tyagis and not have to just work all day and night for maintaining kids and wife, some of you become tyagis and surrender to Gurudev to do big things like Damodar Maharaj and Madhusudan Maharaj and Muni Maharaj. If you, somebody of you go this way, there will be even more powerful.
Mm-hmm.
But if you are Grihastis, you can also preach the same thing as Grihastas. Because anybody can preach. Many of Swami Maharaj's powerful disciples, they were definitely Grihastas.
Unfortunately, when we used to go to Radha Gopinath temple, we were for 4 years, we were considered outsiders. They were told not to associate and talk to us at all.
Huh?